Bora neutron capture therapy is an experimental type of radiotherapy. Radiotherapy involves killing cells using ionizing radiation, mainly through ionization of cell DNA or ionization of water in the cell near the DNA, forming free radicals, which then damage the DNA. With the DNA damaged, the cell dies or loses the ability to reproduce. There are three main types of radiotherapy. External beam radiotherapy uses a beam of radiation such as high-energy X-rays, gamma rays, electron beams, or proton beams, and focuses it directly at the tumor. Sealed source radiotherapy involves placing a radioactive source directly into the body in or next to the tumor through surgery. And finally, there is the unsealed source radiotherapy, which involves injecting or ingesting a soluble radioactive substance designed to concentrate in tumors. BNCT is a distinct type of radiotherapy, different from the three main types listed. It can be thought of as a combination of external beam and unsealed source radiotherapy, amplifying the advantages while reducing the disadvantages of the two types. BNCT involves injecting a tumor-seeking compound tagged with the isotope boron-10, for example sodium tetraborate or sodium borocaptate. After allowing the substance to concentrate at tumors, a beam of epithermal neutrons is directed at this area. Capturing a neutron will induce fission in boron-10. The products of fission are an alpha particle and a lithium-6 ion. These will ideally kill the tumor cell. Going through each of the components carefully, first of all is the neutron beam. The epithermal neutron beam is created from a nuclear reactor, usually a small research reactor fueled from uranium, and filtered from other radiation and slowed down into epithermal neutrons through lead, aluminium, teflon, and cadmium. Then, as the neutron beam travels through the human tissue, it loses its kinetic energy through elastic scattering, the same way a moderator may slow down a neutron in a nuclear reactor. Through the loss of energy, it becomes a thermal neutron, ideal for the boron-10. The neutron beam should ideally not affect the tissue and only be captured by boron-10. This is unfortunately impossible, and other than the scattering of the neutron giving away kinetic energy to the tissue, there are several unwanted nuclear reactions, which are usually more destructive. These are unlikely as the human body is composed of mainly oxygen, carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen. Out of these, oxygen and carbon are very unlikely to capture a neutron, as the neutron cross-sections are very, very small. The neutron cross-sections of an isotope represents the probability of an isotope interacting with the neutron. It is in the units barns, and one barn is equal to 10 to the power of minus 28 meters squared. It is basically how large the cross-section of the nucleus should be for the number of neutrons interacted with to be true. It has nothing to do with the actual size of the nucleus. The term barn came about when a physicist working on radioactivity found that according to the size of the neutron and the number of neutrons that were captured or interacted by a uranium atom, the cross-section of the uranium atom should be as big as a barn. Thus, carbon and oxygen have extremely low neutron cross-sections, at least 5 to 6 orders of magnitude lower than that of boron, and has little to no chance of undergoing a nuclear reaction. Nitrogen and hydrogen also have very small neutron cross-sections, about 2 to 3 orders of magnitude lower than boron, and the nuclear reaction should be unlikely, but due to the sheer number of nitrogen and hydrogen atoms present in the human body, they do produce some nuclear reactions. One of this is the neutron-proton reaction of nitrogen-14, producing an energetic proton in exchange for capturing the neutron. Another one is a reaction of hydrogen, creating deuterium and gamma rays through fusion. Therefore, it is important that the boron concentration is very high in tumors so the neutron delivered can be held to a minimum to avoid these unnecessary reactions. Now let's have a look at the boron. Boron 10 is not radioactive, it has a very high neutron capture cross-section, and it is a naturally occurring isotope. When it captures a thermal neutron, it changes to boron 11 for a brief time, then fissions. The binding energy produced by this reaction goes into the energetic alpha particle, the recoiling lithium 6 ion, and the gamma ray, which occurs 94% of the time. The linear energy transfer of the alpha and lithium particles make them ideal. The linear energy transfer represents the rate of energy transfer to particles per distance. Therefore, high LET means a lot of energy is given, but since more energy is lost at the same time, it cannot go very far. The alpha particle and lithium 6 ion have very high linear energy transfer, and their path lengths, how far they are able to travel before stopping, is smaller than the diameter of the tumor cells. This means, assuming the boron 10 has been deposited in or next to the tumor cell, it should only attack the cell and will do little damage to normal cells. Overall, BNCT is a binary therapy involving neutron radiation and boron 10. Unlike external beam therapy, it is not limited to the surface, nor does the radiation dose have to increase if the targeted tumor is not near the surface. Unlike sealed source, it is non-invasive and the radiation exposure can be controlled. The biological compound injected is initially non-radioactive and safe, unlike unsealed radiotherapy. However, BNCT is still in the development phase. There are several issues that must be addressed. One of this is the lack of effective tumor-seeking compounds. Another issue is the need of a nuclear reactor. This makes it difficult to treat the patients, and a compact neutron accelerator must be developed. BNCT being a binary therapy is an important factor. Binary therapy signifies that there are two components that can be adjusted. Thus, many more variables are involved compared to other therapy. This is both a blessing and a curse. The sheer number of variables means at the beginning of development, it takes much more time to develop and find the optimum values. However, at the end of the day, they will have more flexibility and potential than other forms of radiotherapy, and will prove its worth.